Let me just ask you, Mr. Gujral, about this wider question of what is happening to India's leading opposition party. Now, I know that you are politically, on the other side of the aisle in Punjab, but when you look at, and you know, you've been critical of Amrinder Singh and his government, but when you look at what has happened to Amrinder Singh and the way this entire business was handled, what is that telling you about the state of the Congress?
Well, you asked me two or three questions. The first question, the state of the Congress party. Well, actually, it's become a private limited company. And I think it's high time that they go in for an IPO. Because like many of the startups who have gone in for IPO, they become unicorns overnight. I think if Congress party was to become a larger party, an open party, a lot of talent of experienced leaders who left the party,
right,
who have formed their own parties, would probably come back. But today the state of the Congress party is that even those who are inside are feeling suffocated. Look at this group of 23. They're all senior experienced leaders. And I know for a fact that they're not just 23 people. Anybody that you speak to in the Congress party, and I meet them all in the central hall, everybody feels suffocated and they want some kind of release. So if they go on like this, they'll be history very soon.
But you know,
as far as Amrinder Singh is... As far as Amrinder Singh is concerned, it's a shame. He's an experienced leader. Single-handedly, he won Punjab for them. They got close to 80 seats. Now, it's a fact that there was total non-performance for the last 4.5 years. It is also a fact that they did nothing for the Dalits and the poor. And now suddenly, as a symbol, they put a Dalit chief minister there. But the fact remains, he should have been treated in a dignified manner. He should not have been humiliated the way he's been humiliated. He's a senior national leader. And it's a shame to treat your own leaders like this.
Okay, so you're making an interesting point, because though as I said, you know, the Akalis, you're against, or you've been opposed to the Congress government in Punjab, and as you said, according to you, they've done nothing for all these years. You're saying the manner in which Amrinder Singh was turfed out, that was poorly done, even though there could have been a case for replacing him, because there was a lot of anti-incumbency.
Well, there's a dignified way of doing things. In fact, at one stage, he had put in his papers and he was persuaded by Mrs. Sonia Gandhi to stay on.
Right.
And then to be booted out the way he was. It's not done in politics, and especially to senior leaders. And I'm sure as a result, they'll pay a heavy price for this.
Okay, a heavy price, you mean in the polls?
Absolutely.
Okay. But tell me your wider concern. When you look at the fact that increasingly you have a country where there is no real now serious national opposition party. As you said, the Congress has become this sort of private concern or private limited or whatever. What does that portend for us as a democracy?
Look, for a healthy democracy, we need a vibrant opposition. And it is a fact that Congress is a very important party. They have their offices all over the country. They still get a large vote share. But unfortunately, they have zero leadership. And as a result, it's dwindling. And also as a result of that, BJP is becoming stronger. So right. I do feel that we need a strong party at the center. We also need very strong regional parties, which is very important. Regional parties which are not controlled by remote control from the center.
Right.
And coming back to my state of Punjab, we are suffering today because of the remote control in Delhi. And I would say that also for the Aam Aadmi Party, which has ambitions in Punjab.
Right.
But if the remote control is going to be in Delhi, then it's not going to be healthy for Punjab.
What's your if the Congress continues as it is, I mean, with the or the absence of a strong challenge to the BJP at the center, you think that even in the next, Lok Sabha elections 2024, it's going to be the same story?
I think Congress will implode much before that. The way they are going, they will implode after the UP elections. And I'm sure there will be a huge revolt and a new party will be formed. And at that stage, I expect a lot of Congress leaders who had left the party and who made their own outfits, they will probably come back and make a new, vibrant, healthy party.
I see. And that you think could take on the BJP in 2024?
Absolutely. But for that, we have to wait for the 22 election.
Okay.
This will happen post-UP when Congress will be in the single digits.
Okay. Well, you seem to be, though you're not a congressman, you seem to have a fairly confident sense of how things are going to play out in the Congress. But thank you very much indeed, Mr. Gujral, for joining us as candid as ever. Thanks very much indeed.